And viewers, amidst reports of Congress infighting, Kumari Sailja has spoken exclusively to Times Now. Listen in to what she has to say on this entire controversy.
Joined by the senior Haryana Congress leader and the Lok Sabha MP, Kumari Sailja, with us, ma'am, as continuously BJP is also asking this question. It's also in the minds of many of the Congress members are also that why are you missing on the ground? Why no campaigning has been done for the assembly election since there is a ticket distribution process has been over?
Yeah, you know, in the beginning, there are candidates who have to work on the ground, and because we don't really have an organization at the grassroots level for a long time. Workers are there. So to put everything right, candidates need time, and now we'll all hit the trail and we'll work for the party and for Congress to form the government.
Ma'am, no dissent within Haryana Congress, because we have seen that how you were also seeking a ticket for yourself that has not been given. So is it all okay within the Haryana Congress also?
See, these are separate issues. These are internal issues of the party, and they are discussed at a different level. But all of us are party soldiers.
Ma'am, yesterday a meeting has also taken place where the Congress president was also there. Any assurance has also been given by the Congress High Command to you?
See, there's nothing. There are discussions on different levels and at for different issues.
Ma'am, an open offer has also been given by the BJP for you to join the BJP.
Yeah, would that happen? That's the funny one. That's the funny
one. But would that happen, ma'am? Any chances?
How can it happen?
You will be in Congress party only, ma'am.
See, I don't have to say it. You'll see it. You see my past history and you'll see the future. I don't have to say these things, you know. It's just that because I was silent for a short while that BJP wanted to, you know, play in that vacant ground, so to say. So they've been saying all kinds of things, but they also know. They also know that Sailja will never join BJP or any other party.
Ma'am, a caste slur was also being raised against you. But the BJP is saying that it's an insult to the entire Dalit community, as the Congress party is against the Dalit community.
I think, you know, it's not just an insult to the Dalit community. It's an insult to the entire society. Anyone who holds such views, and even if people say that they may be their personal views, that's how some people have said. I don't think that has any place in today's society, and there are right-thinking people in every community. So to say this about one certain community, I think it's also insulting the entire gamut of communities of the society. So there are right-thinking people. There may be some people who harbor these, but then is that right? That is for everybody to judge.
Well, last question, ma'am. Many of the people are also demanding that you should become the chief minister when Congress party will form a government. Will their aspirations be fulfilled?
That is for the high command to decide.
Your opinion.
See, these are different things. These issues have to be settled after the elections. And high command will settle them.
Would you like to express your wish?
That we'll talk later.
That we'll talk later. Niyamika is now joining us on the broadcast. Niyamika, you had a conversation earlier exclusively with Kumari Sailja. You asked her pointed questions. She did not deny any of those things, you know, specifically about not being given ticket and how in the last few days we have seen, you know, many people suggesting that she is upset because of the way tickets, etc. were distributed. She felt sidelined. She said that there are discussions at different levels, means definitely something is not right as far as Kumari Sailja and the Congress party is concerned, isn't it?
Well, yes, definitely there is something which is not right within Haryana Congress, and that is the only reason why Kumari Sailja was not being seen anywhere on the ground holding any campaigns, holding any public rallies for the assembly elections. Because before this ticket distribution process, we have seen that how Kumari Sailja had taken out a yatra all across the state, in which she was also trying that a positive message should be given to the people of Haryana, so that a government of the Congress party will be formed in the next few days, as the assembly elections date is was being announced at that point of time also. But soon after this ticket distribution process was over, soon after this official list was being released by the Congress Party, we have seen that Kumari Shailja was nowhere within Haryana. We have seen that many of the leaders were also demanding that she should be campaigning on the ground, as she is a prominent leader for the Congress Party in the state of Haryana. She was also the PCC president in 2019, and all of these factors were there, but still Kumari Shailja was not being seen on the ground. And when this pointed question was being asked to her, she had said that it is because the organizational level, there is no organization at the grassroots level there, and the candidates need some time to make preparations, and now we are going to start our campaign trail in next 2 to 3 days. But that is what she is saying to us. But on the other side, it is a meeting which had also taken place yesterday evening, where the Congress president held talks with Kumari Shailja, as there was a dissent which was clearly being seen, as Kumari Shailja was not being anywhere for the campaigning. She was not giving any statements. She was not denying any kind of allegations which were being leveled against the Congress party from the point of view of the BJP. No statement had come at that point of time. But yesterday there was a meeting that had taken place where all these dissent were being expressed by Kumari Shailja to the Congress President Mallika Arjun Kharge. And it is being interesting to see that soon after that particular meeting, today morning, it was Randeep Singh Surjewala who had made a tweet in this regard, and he has also said that Kumari Shailja will start her campaigning from 26 September, as she is going to hold a public meeting in the Narwana constituency. So clearly it seems like an assurance might be given by the Congress High Command to Kumari Shailja, and then only she has now been decided to start her campaigning for the assembly elections.
Right, but if we look at the events, you know, that have taken place in the in the last few days, firstly, when the Congress manifesto was being released, Kumari Shailja, who is an important person, an important leader as far as Haryana Congress is concerned, was not present. Today, there were supposed to be some events that were supposed to be held by Mallikarjun Kharge as part of his campaign in Haryana that got cancelled. And now also, is there any assurity that you've got from Kumari Shailja herself that she is ready to hit the ground very soon? Was she excited when you spoke to her about the upcoming polls?
Well, clearly she has given a hint, because soon after this meeting only, it is now Kumari Shailja who is also speaking to the media. She has also said that she will soon going to start her campaign trail within the state, as on from 26th onwards she is going to address a public meeting first in Narwana, and after that there will be the proper campaigning schedule which is also going to be prepared on the part of Kumari Shailja for the assembly elections. But clearly this is a hint which she has also given, that this has come just after a meeting had taken place at the residence of Congress President Mallika Arjun Kharge, where all this dissent was being expressed on her part, whatever she was feeling at that point of time. Because we have also seen that during the ticket distribution process also, majority of the tickets are being given to the candidates who belongs to the Hooda camp. And we have also got this information from our sources that at that particular point of time, Kumari Shailja was seeking at least 30 to 35 tickets in the assembly elections, but at most she has got just 8 to 9 candidates in this list which is being released by the Congress party for the list for the candidates for assembly elections. And that was the major reason why she was not really happy with the manner in which this entire process was being followed. Many of her close aides were denied tickets, and not just her close aides, but also she was also seeking a ticket for herself from the seat of Uklana. That is also being denied on her part, and that was the major reason why she was quite upset from the Congress party regarding this entire
matter. So we have to actually wait till at least 26th of September whether she actually will begin her campaigning or not in Haryana, because there are still few days in between, and we are seeing continuous attacks coming in from the Bharatiya Janata Party as well on this.